From the moment you come into Paulo, you can tell that it's a family-run business and that we have great people at Paulo, from the ownership to the executives to each department and each plant.
I think if you look back to the very beginning of Paulo, people would be astounded to see where we are right now. It's grown slowly over the years, but I think it's grown far beyond what those that were initially involved, particularly my grandmother and grandfather, would have imagined.
In 1943, Ben and Pauline Rasher founded Paulo Products Company. Though they didn't originally set out to start a heat treating company, the need throughout the St. Louis area caused Ben to focus on this service while looking for a product to make.
Paulo was started after my father left Central Mine Equipment Company. There had been a family dispute that caused him and my mother to leave.
I think that most people are surprised, maybe even shocked, to know that my grandfather and grandmother would have given up everything essentially that they had done professionally to start a heat treat shop, and frankly, it was my grandmother's idea.
My great-grandmother, her name was Pauline. She was one of the first females to graduate with an engineering degree. And in the 40s, when the company was founded, my great-grandfather, who was actually the businessman, wanted to attribute the name of the company to her.
He wasn't sure whether heat treating would continue to be his business.
He named it Paulo Products Company because he thought he was going to develop a product. But in order to pay the bills initially, they knew how to heat treat and thought he would do what he knew how to do to serve others while he was trying to develop this product.
Now, this is a diagram of the building at 2907 Washington Avenue. In order to get going, what they did was they went to junkyards and bought the parts necessary to build the equipment that they first used for heat treating. That was the beginning of Paulo Products Company.
Because of the need for heat treating services in St. Louis and the small company's focus on making their customers successful, the Paulo Products Company built their first plant at 5600 West Park Avenue in St. Louis, which still stands today.
My father had planned on moving from the building there on Washington Avenue. He bought this land here that 5711 West Park is on. When he built the building, he put heat treating equipment in half of the building, and the other 40 foot wide, 120 feet, was used for doing some kind of manufacturing. As it turned out, the products that he had in mind to make were not successful, but the heat treating continued to be a success.
As the 50s rolled around, the heat treating market in St. Louis was changing greatly. Competitors moved in, and the needs of the customers were taking the plant's capabilities to its limits. These changes forced Paulo to adapt to stay relevant within the industry.
In the 1950s, the largest heat treater in the United States, Lindbergh Heat Treating Company, put a plant in on East Taylor Avenue and went into competition with us. It was a very difficult time.
Because of the well-received reputation that Paulo had created, the 60s brought notable jobs to the Paulo Products Company, including treating track pins from salvaged WW2 tanks, M14 rifle magazines, brazing 106mm artillery shell casings, and assembling and brazing 6.5 million fuel pump housings per year.
We did 106mm shells for Kisco, and the job was to braze the end in the shell. So we'd lay these parts down in the furnace and send them through. Problem, the disc fell out.
My grandfather and Mike Hafley took a chalk string and stretched it horizontally the length of the furnace on both sides, and then cut the furnace shell with a torch on both sides, took out what they call glow bars, which are the heating elements, and then they took jacks and jacked up the furnace so that this clearance on the inside was tall enough so that they could run these through standing up, and they welded new sides in, reinstalled the glow bars, and had everything set up. They did that all in one weekend.
It was our ability to take jobs like that, that were large, and make them a success.
The 60s also marked the decade that Paulo would enter the world of computing by becoming the first heat treater to install a computer to aid in processing orders.
I realized that computers might be the answer to order writing and our billing more efficient, more accurate. I started out with an IBM 1130. This was a computer that used punch card input. We could write an order, we had the billing instructions for that order, and produce the invoices that were necessary from it.
The 70s brought the company a period of growth when, in 1972, Paulo built a 3,200 square foot treatment plant in Kansas City.
One of the tool steel salesmen here in St. Louis also sold tool steel in Kansas City. And he told us that the heat treating that was being done in Kansas City was not very good. So what we did was we had an employee that had a pickup truck, and we sent the employee to Kansas City twice a week, and we picked up the dye work in Kansas City and brought it back here and processed it. So the thing that occurred to us is that the plan would be to put in a small plant in Kansas City.
It started in one tiny room, which is our current vacuum room over there. From that point on, we've grown from that garage to about 100,000 square feet there in Kansas City.
Even more growth was achieved in the 1980s. In 1983, Paulo purchased Olin Metal Products in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Shortly after, in 1988, three more plants were purchased from U.S. Steel Supply in Birmingham, Alabama, Cleveland, Ohio, and Nashville, Tennessee.
When I started, we had one plant. 5 years later, in 1973, we started our Kansas City facility. Shortly after that, acquisitions with Memphis, Murfreesboro, and then Nashville, Birmingham, and Cleveland, and all of a sudden we were a seven-plant company. And it put a lot of strain on us, obviously, but it was so exciting that you didn't really mind the strain.
In the 1990s, Paulo again showcased their innovation and industry-changing methods by unveiling their self-designed quality assurance software, the PIC system, in 1996.
Since the 60s, we'd had some computerized system, but PICs was the first time that we really attempted to capture every step in the process.
Back when I started 30 years ago, we didn't really have recipes for parts when they came in. So literally, every time the parts come in, they had the opportunity to see something completely different. What PIX has really changed is we have a very unique customer part relationship. So every time that part comes in, it's gonna see exactly the same thing.
The first place that we put the system in was in Kansas City. And then I was able to sell other plants on the idea. Then something happened that I never expected. And that was that my engineering department started using the data and developing their own systems using the data that we have here. And so we were able to integrate this whole thing into engineering applications and business applications together.
Despite the ups and downs of the 2000s, Paulo steadily grew, forming the foundation from which they are now going international. As Paulo celebrates its 75th anniversary, the company is thriving today and looking toward the future. Paulo has begun construction on its first international division in Monterrey, Mexico.
I think it's really exciting that we're building our plant in Mexico and all this is coming together in our 75th year.
I envision Paulo in the future to be not just one of the largest commercial heat treaters in the Midwest, but I see us having more of a global footprint. And we've already taken steps in that direction by opening this plant in Mexico that will have new opportunities in places outside of just the United States to make an impact and have a presence there.
We're going to be providing an FNC process to a customer down there, which I'm really excited about. It's an emerging automotive market that we're going to be dealing with, and it really allows us to position ourselves for the future and take advantage of a new market.
So much has changed for the company throughout its 75 years of business, but one thing that has remained the same is the dedication to uphold the company's values from the Rasher family. With three generations of the family at the helm of the company and a fourth on its way, the company has held true to the vision that Ben had set forth in 1943.
There's not many companies today where you see multiple generations, whether you're in the office or on the shop floor. Not only my family has multiple generations here, but operators who are loading furnaces, their fathers worked here, they work here, and now their kids work here.
We are such a family-oriented company, and family is so important. Honestly, the first thing that comes to my mind being a part of such a legacy is pride. It is so cool that my great-grandpa started this and built this, and I'm a part of it, and I think it's the neatest thing ever.
Everybody that's here wants to be here, and everybody that's here works closely together, and we've been able to do it while maintaining those strong familial bonds.
So how do you stay in business for 75 years? It takes more than a service offered to customers. It also takes much more than a loyal family. You need dedicated, passionate people who believe that the company is more than the sum of its parts. You need people with integrity who are interested in helping their customers succeed.
I feel fortunate in that I worked with four generations of Rashers. And starting with Ben and Pauline, and continuing through with Frank, Ben, Terry, Tom, and Ben and Terry's children, probably the most important passion that they have is for the people who work there.
Without our people, we're nothing. And I think that our people are so important. They bring so much knowledge to the table. And I think that absolutely works in our favor.
Everyone is supportive. Everyone wants to help each other. And everyone has the same interest in Paulo succeeding, as the Rasher family does. And we're all family.
Paulo attracts innovators. It attracts people with the ability to design, engineer, work as teams to come up with great new innovations to meet our customer demands.
The underlying ability to do it is the people that carry out the plan.
We want to thank all the dedicated employees over the past 75 years. Those who have worked with us in the past, work with us today, and will work with us in the future.